Hey, Arik, say hello. Hey, baby. So I'm right here changing Arik's diaper. I have the wet wipes here. I have his butt cream. I have Arik here. I have diapers, and I'm doing it just on the table because going up and down upstairs is not working. Oh, baby. Oh, baby. And then we could also change him here downstairs, but Keon is sleeping in that room, so he's not gonna work. Okay, guys, there has been an emergency. Somebody needed to get washed. I needed to wash Yarik really quickly because when I was starting to change his diaper, I realized that he had pooped all the way to his neck. Yeah, so I needed to like take some action. So I put him in the kitchen sink and he's really enjoying himself. He's not very comfortable, but I'm doing my best just to clean him up and soak him for a little while. And then he's gonna get out of here. Get out of here. Or not, baby. Motherhood is no joke, you guys. You think this and then that happens, doesn't it, baby? Especially poop actions. He really likes it. Yarik is much better in water than Keon. Keon would be crying by now, or he'd be looking a little bit scared, but Yarik is like, I want to be in the water. I want to be in the water. He's gonna cry when I take him out of here, aren't you? Aren't you, baby? Aren't you, baby? So this is real life, guys.
This is really the real life.
This is real life. Papa is coming home.
That's really the real life. And also really the real life is that I give you my cold hand.
Oh my god, my god. He put cold hands.
It's the real life.
No, baby, I'm busy with Yarik.
Yeah.
No, don't do that.
Don't do that.
I say sorry.
It's so real life. Say sorry.
Real life, annoying husband. Jane is making.
Wait,
does
it need to boil like this?
Yeah. Jane is making food over there, and I'm washing baby's poop right here. This is real life. Real than this, you will not have it. No, you will not have it. You will not have it. Let's take him out of here. Come. Yeah, baby. See, guys. If you're from Kenya, you know this. You know this. I use this on my baby's skin. When this is finished, I know already where to get it. I will buy it at Betty's. You know Kenyan delicacies. If you watch the other video where I showed you where to get Kenyan products, you can also buy this here. It's really good on their skin. It is what we used to do. We used to use when I was young, when I was small. I'm still young, but when I was small, that's what we used to use, and I like it on my baby's skin. It's really nice. So I'm still in my bathrobe most of the days when I'm just at home. This is my outfit because it's really easy to just take it out and breastfeed Yarik, and it's very convenient, especially when I'm just the whole day at home. Yarik, let's put this one on first. When I'm just at home, then I don't need to dress up anymore, like, unless otherwise. Sometimes I do, but most of the time I'm just in my bathroom. Today was really hectic. Today, I should have started this vlog this morning, but this is just a random vlog. Hey, Yarik. Mama is talking too much. Oh! baby. Hello. Okay, guys, like I was saying, this is just a baby. A baby. Okay, so I've decided to wear a yarek so that I can be able to do some things with my hands. Things like, the temperature dropped. And we want it to be at 21. And then I ordered this. I don't know how you say that. Do you say full car or four car? Baby electric nail file. This is how it looks. Wait, I will take it out of the packaging. Okay. So this is what was in the box. USB cable, because you can charge it. Like I said, it's electrical. And then a folder with instructions. They have obviously instructions here. It looks really cute. Look at that. This thing looks really cute. So they have like number one, they have numbers over there up to number nine. It's like number one is 0 to 3 months, the white one. So that one I'm going to use on Yarek. Number four, 12 plus Manda, that is 12 plus months. The green one, that one is Kayon's. I'm really curious about this. When Yarek is awake, I'm gonna try it. See how it works. Okay. Today we are eating arrowroots. So the ones I ordered also, like when I showed you the video, when I made the video of where to buy Kenyan or African products here in the Netherlands, we ordered these ones, and that's what we are gonna eat today. So Jane is gonna make it. I think she's going to boil it, eh? Yeah, she's gonna boil it. She's gonna prepare it really good, wash it really good, and then boil it, and then we're gonna eat it with beef stew. Go put on the lights. The way you put them on, you put them out. Huh? Over there. Jane, Keon is going to your bathroom. Good job, Keon. Let's give them a tour.
Bill?
Jane and Keon went to the bathroom.
Yeah, like that.
To wash their hands.
Okay,
let me just give a small glimpse of Jane's bathroom. I'm here dancing while holding Yarek. Here's Yarek. John is going outside with Papa. They're gonna play outside in the cold. Put on the lights, Gail. Put on the lights. Good job. Good job. Okay, go. Papa is waiting. Did you?
Come.
Are you going to give us a baby? So we just fed Yarek after he slept for how long already? Oh, there was a small one. He slept, I think, for 3.5 hours, right? I was holding him and then, I was walking around. So I was planning to walk around here, like around the table, around the kitchen counter for like 50 times. I was able to walk 41 times because baby Yarek woke up and he wanted to drink and he had no patience. No patience, you're just like your papa, eh? Impatient. Mm-hmm. Just like papa. So guys, it has been a really long day today. It is 5 o'clock. And Keon is like, I think he's having the sleep regression, the ones that children get when they're 18 months old, because Keon is a really bad sleeper nowadays. He doesn't sleep really good. So he wakes up sometimes at 5 in the morning, sometimes at 20 minutes before 5, sometimes at 6. And we change his routine that he goes to bed at 7, so hoping that he would sleep from 7 to 7, but he's not there yet. Let's just say the longest he slept since we changed his routine was until 6:20 in the morning. But his father is traveling. Normally he would be going to Keon at 5. Yesterday we put him to bed at 7, and then at around 11 he woke up crying. I don't know if he had a dream or whatever. So his papa went to him and then he put him back to bed. And Keon was really, really, he didn't want to go back to sleep. So he was awake until 1 o'clock. Mama cannot sleep when his son is awake or whatever. So I couldn't also put Yarek down, because when Yarek hears Keon crying, he will also not sleep. And then I was holding Yarek. Actually, I hold Yarek almost the whole night through, because some of you know that, if you don't know, he has got reflux, and when you put him down to lay on his back, then the milk comes up and he's very uncomfortable and all that. So to avoid that, I always like hold him almost throughout the night. I can talk about that later, but Keon was really fussy and crying and not really happy until 1 o'clock in the night. After that, I put Yarek in bed. 37 minutes later, Yarek, the milk started to come up, you guys. And then it's like, then I need to soothe him. I need to give him pacifier the whole time. And before, I was sleeping. I don't even know how long I slept. I think 1 hour and 37 minutes in total in the night. 5 o'clock, 2 minutes to 5, my dear Keon is awake. So then I went down. I gave Yarek to Jane. Jane is our au pair. I don't know. I keep saying that because people will be like, who is Jane? Is that your other daughter or something? So Jane, she's my daughter. I'm her host mother. So I gave Yarek to Jane and then I went in to sleep with Keon. I took Keon out of his bed. I was holding him and then he fell asleep immediately on my shoulder. And then I went and laid down with him in the bed next to his little bed. And he was a little bit awake for a while. And then he fell asleep and he was like, Mama, Mama. And then he fell asleep. But Mama wasn't sleeping. Mama was, I was having mom guilt, because I had given Yarek to Jane when he was still awake and it was still very early, because when I don't sleep in the night, and I always give Yarek to Jane like around 6, so then I can eat something and then at around 7 I can go back to sleep for some few hours. But then he was still awake at 5. He just had like something to drink between 4 and 5. And I was feeling really bad. I was happy that I was holding my Keon and I was sleeping next to Keon, but I was also feeling a little bit guilty because of Yarek. I don't know if you guys can understand me. I think if you're a mother, you understand what I'm talking about. Like, mom guilt is a real thing. We always want to be with our babies full time. Like, I'm always saying that if I had superpowers, I would like take away sleep out of my life, and then I would be like 24/7 with my babies. But that is not possible. I'm just wishful thinking. It is so. It has been a long day. So then I stayed with Keon, and Yarik was already no. And then Keon slept until 7. After 7, I woke up, I fed him, and all that. I stayed with him, and by the time I was going back to bed, it was almost 10 o'clock in the morning, you guys. So I slept just a little bit until few minutes to 1, because at 1, Keo needs to go back to bed, and I was sleeping in his bedroom. So it has been just... My God, it has been a dramatic day today. But yes, I'm tired, but I'm content. I'm happy with my babies, and we need to change things. So I always sit upright on my bed when I'm holding Yarik throughout the night, and I realize that I'm starting to have back problems and all that. So we need to change things, and I think I should start vlogging. Jesus Christ, what am I saying? I think I should start vlogging more, like share with you guys our day to day. What do you think? Would you like to see that, our day to day? Because I vlog just sometimes, not always, like I post at least 2 videos a week. Would you like to see more, like, because I feel like I have a lot to share with you guys that let me know in the comment section below if it something that you would like that I vlog more, show you about our lives when possible, obviously, and let me know, okay? But that was my day, that was our day actually, and Jane made a delicious meal that I will show you guys in just a bit, and then I think we will end the video. Thank you very much for watching. My baby Yarik, say bye-bye. Baby Yarik, bye-bye. Thank you guys for watching. Keon is outside with his papa. They went outside for a while so that Keon can get some fresh air. We also need to start going outside. I need to start exercising, you guys. Get me back to shape. After 2 babies in 2 years, man, this body needs to be, I need to start working out and become strong again, like for myself, you know, and also this mom belly. Maybe I should show you one time, like how my belly looks like now after 2 babies back to back. Would you like to see that? Okay. Let me know in the comment section below. I'll catch you guys in the next one. Okay, stay tuned to see the food that Jane made. I will show you. Okay guys, bye-bye. Hey, don't forget to like, share and subscribe. Okay, share with your friends, families, tell them about baby Yarik. Okay say bye-bye. Bye guys, bye-bye.
Me, I'm quiet is my middle name.
Yeah.
Onike, what's your middle name? Mr. Quiet too?
Baby, I need to film.
Yes, me too.
Shh.
Hi guys.
Okay. You guys. Hi guys.
Hi guys. Yeah.
Oh my God. Dina has been served. So Jane made the
delicious. Local.
Yeah.
Australian.
So Jane made delicious local Kenyan, not Australian food. We have here arrowroots. The other time I was calling them yam. Some of you told me, hey, it's not yam, it's arrowroots. Nduma, you guys, with beef stew, and then is mishiri na carrots, French beans, and a little bit of carrots. This was actually leftovers from the other day, so I'm salivating. I'm gonna eat. Bye bye guys.
You want carrots?